Thank you for taking 10 minutes for commercial-free current events. This is CNN Student News. I'm Carl Azuz, and I'm glad to see you. You probably haven't heard of Masdar City. It's located near the Persian Gulf in the United Arab Emirates. It's basically this large-scale experiment, a model for the city of the future. But its cost is $18 billion. Its success is uncertain. As Erin Burnett found out on a tour of Masdar City, part of the project's value lies in what could be.
About 20 miles outside Abu Dhabi, Masdar City is striving to be the greenest city on Earth.
I think the city of the future is going to be based on people walking to where they live, to where they work, and to where they play.
And if you aren't walking, City Director Tony Mallow says you can take a magnetically controlled car wherever you need to go.
Welcome to Masdar City.
This is a little car?
Yeah, this is personal rapid transit. This is how you get around the city. Driverless, it's electrical and solar powered. It comes when you want it and it takes you when you want to go and you leave it alone.
So it's driverless?
Yes.
Navigating the city's 2.4 square miles is relatively easy.
This is a dream of what the future could be. But is it really going to happen? I mean, is this going to be anything more than a demo?
It's a model for urban development, but it's really sustainable because it's not only environmentally sustainable, socially and economically.
Fewer than 500 people live here. That falls far short of the original goal of 40,000 by next year, a goal set at the peak of the economic boom. Right now, about 1,200 people work here every day, in buildings that are specially designed to help reduce water and energy consumption by as much as 40%, according to city officials. With more than 87,000 solar panels, the city produces its own electricity, offsetting 15,000 tons of carbon emissions a year. City engineers say that's the equivalent of taking about 3,300 cars off the road in Abu Dhabi. And walking around the city, innovation can be seen everywhere.
So you're looking at a wind tower, which is a traditional Arabic design to cool, right?
Yes, absolutely. So you take a traditional Arabic element on cooling, totally passive energy, totally sustainable, and then you use modern technology to make it even more efficient.
The Masdar Institute is also partnered with MIT to develop new renewable energy sources, like making jet fuel from the seed of a weed that grows here in the desert.
So this is obviously happening here.
Yes.
In the middle of the desert. Your ambition or what you're trying to prove is much bigger.
Absolutely. I mean, globalization is the key issue for the future. Not only because cities are going to attack global warming, we have to understand how to build cities that are low carbon. And that's why Masdar City is such an important contribution to globalization and urbanization.